That is me, and my name is Chester.
That's our band.
Get yourself some tickets.
Get yourself some tickets.
You can go get yourself some tickets.
Yeah, you thought that too.
I'm good! It's not a good idea.
So if you don't like Mexican food, I don't like you.
I always remember being drawn to music in a way that I just felt compelled to sing. I felt compelled to feel the music in a way that was important.
Without a sense of confidence, I'm convinced that this is too much pressure to take.
I felt this way before.
So insecure!
Music that we listen to really is, kind of like it's kind of like the clothes we wear. It kind of shows people who we are and what we're about, and without, having to really get to know somebody. Or
my dream when I was a young kid was to be a Broadway theater star. That was my dream. That was my ultimate goal, until I got on stage and played music for the first time, and then I was like, I want to do that.
Music should be your life, period. You need to live it. You need to eat it, sleep it, wake up, and the only way you're ever even going to have a chance to make it in this business is if you are willing to sacrifice everything to achieve your goal.
Rainbow is my favorite color, by the way. That's what I tell my kids.
Sparkly.
This is to raise money for ALS, otherwise known as Lou Gehrig's disease. Woo! I'm going to accept the bucket. I will also make a donation on behalf of my family. Hi. This is Tyler, Lila, and Lily. Okay, here we go.
Oh my God.
I felt like we had made it when I started hearing other artists, like country artists covering like One Step Closer, doing like a banjo hoedown version of the song, or like a polka version of In the End or something. And I think that kind of shows how broad the spectrum can be.
The reach.
Of the reach. Yeah. We get
it's almost like somebody, I'm just waiting for somebody to pinch me and wake me up, you know? But it's something that we never expected. And I think that, you know, we were shocked, like thoroughly shocked when we released the album in the States.
Letters all the time. I meet our fans a lot, and I've had the pleasure of meeting some people who have literally walked up and handed me a letter and amazing story that they've told, and sometimes they're very dramatic and very full of horrible things that have happened to them, and then, you know, at the end of it, it says this particular song is what got me through that moment. And that is a really wonderful feeling, because that's not what we're writing the songs for. We're writing the songs, you know, because we enjoy making music and because we want people to like the songs that we write, but we don't really set out for a specific song to really change somebody's life. We just hope that people can relate to it and enjoy it. And so when it goes to that level, it's an honor.
And the song basically deals with emotions of frustration and feelings of insecurity within yourself and dealing with the problems that are happening in your life.
Right when you think you've got it all figured out and everything's good, it just comes and kicks you right in the nuts. And then every time you think it can't get any worse and that life sucks and it's never going to get better, all of a sudden, the sun comes a-shining.
It got to a point where the person that I knew who I was in my mind and in my soul, I wasn't being that person outwardly in the world. And so that kind of fucks with you a little bit, the success of what I love to do. And that's when everything else caught up at the same time. So the stuff that I was carrying from my childhood with that, coupled with probably the fact that I was successful and I could kind of disappear for a while, you know, I think that was a perfect combination for a lot of things where I needed to, you know, reevaluate how I wanted to live my life. And so the band came and helped me out, and we, you know, I got rid of a lot of things and replaced a lot of things with some good people around me and good positive experiences that weren't just the band. Well, I think for me, music was always the one thing that I enjoyed the most of it, about life, and it was the one thing that was consistently, especially in this group, consistently paying off. Anyways, gears were clicking on really high levels, but for me, things just weren't really moving in every other aspect of my life, moving in the same direction. But it was also like, okay, I'm going to like now go work on enjoying the rest of life outside of making music, because I was just like a mess. I was just kind of surviving. And so it was really a fun time for the band, even though it was a very difficult time. I think it was a really inspiring time, and it was a really, it was where we went from being, for me it was like, I want to be friends with you guys, but I don't really know you guys. And it was like 9 months, you know, a year later, we're signed, and 2 years later, we've got like the biggest debut, one of the biggest debuts of all time.
This is my December. This is my time of the year. This is my December. This is all so clear. This is my December. This is my snow-covered home. This is my December. This is me.
Something I missed.
And I
to
see.
film, you know, I don't know. Yeah, I mean, maybe down the road when I become more distinguished looking. And I think it may have probably pigeonholed myself into character roles because of the way I look now. So. Alright guys, as much as I'd love to stay and chat with you guys, I have to get home to my kitties, my kids. So it's been a lot of fun. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I know I always have a great time chatting with you guys. Till then, see you guys later. Thanks. Bye. Back home when life leaves us blind, love keeps us kind.